So this is a story that I would ordinarily tell more for a personal healing or for a therapeutic setting where someone's been abused and they need to find their truth. But more and more as I've come to Bentley, I realize that this story is also appropriate here. It comes from India, and once it gets surreal, so just stay with me, but I know you guys can. Once there was a woman who would not sing her song, who would not tell her story, and who would not dance her dance. And the song, the dance, and the story were really upset about this, as you can imagine. And so they tried to wake her up. They gave her dreams. At first they gave her enticing dreams to inspire her to sing her song, tell her story, and dance her dance. But she wasn't listening and she didn't understand. So they ramped up the dreams until they were terrible nightmares. They got more and more terrifying until she would wake up with a cold sweat, these terrible monsters. But she didn't understand the language that the dreams were trying to speak to her. And still she didn't sing her song. And still she didn't dance her dance. Until still she didn't tell her story. So in frustration, one night, the song, the dance and the story cooked up great ideas. This is great ideas that have been cooked up at Bentley over the last few months and years. And they cooked up this amazing plot to really get her attention. And this is what they did. The song turned itself into a man's hat. The story turned itself into a man's coat. And the dance turned itself into a pair of men's shoes and placed themselves in the house where such things were placed. And as you can imagine, when her husband came home from a day's work, he said, wife, whose shoes are these? And whose coat is this? And whose hat is this? And she came out to look and quite innocently said, well, I don't know. I've never seen them before. What do you mean you've never seen them before? And a fight erupted, and before you knew it, they're having a terrible argument. She was tear-stained and he was grumpy. And so he went off to the spa, to the baths, to talk to his friends about his faithless wife, as you do, especially if you live in Mullumbimby with a kid as that. And so the wife, she didn't know what to do, so she just went to bed to cry, and she snuffed out all the candles, all the lamps. And so since the flames didn't have anything to do, this is where it gets surreal, the flames decided to go also to the bathhouse and talk to their friends who are now off work. And so the man, he'd spilled his beans to his friends about his faithless wife, and even she was a liar, she couldn't even admit that she had a man visiting her. And he'd gotten it off his chest, and all the friends had gone home. He was just sitting quietly when he heard the flames talking. Oh, you should have seen the fight that happened in our place. And they told the story. And he listened, and he went and got dressed, and he went home, and he felt so much better. He didn't have a faithless wife. It was a simpler problem, he thought, than that. And so he went home, and he lit the lamp beside the bed, and he kissed his wife, and he said, sweetheart, wake up. Tell me, darling, why don't you sing your song? Why don't you tell your story? And why don't you dance your dance? And she rubbed her eyes, and she said, what? What song? What story? What dance? And ordinarily I tell that story to get everyone to think, what song are you not singing? What story are you not telling? And what dance are you not dancing? But here at Bentley, it feels like collectively we have all come together, as the beautiful speeches have all encapsulated, we've all come together to sing the earth song and to tell the earth story. And to dance the earth dance. And that's what makes, for me, Bentley so special. We haven't just talked science, we haven't just made films, we haven't just lobbied, we haven't just done one thing or another that's just of the mainstream world. We've taken the spirit and the song and the dance and the story of the earth, and we've brought that out so beautifully in so many beautiful ways. And that, I think, is what was going to sustain this beautiful ripple which will spread throughout the world and already is.